Praise the Lord. This is Reverend Moses Mukholi. I want to thank the Lord who has given me opportunity to come and share the message of the Lord during this Easter season. Easter has been so good as we come to the Holy Week, where Jesus Christ, after being in the wilderness and coming to choose the servants of the Lord, whom he called disciples, and after that, he had to tell them the mission that his Father had sent him. And this mission he sent even to the disciples, and the disciples entrusted it to us. And this is the reason we come today, this Easter week, as we pass on the message of Christ. The theme is, I am looking for my brothers. This is what I want to base on. Looking for my brothers, this is a message which began right with our son to the great person called Jacob. And Jacob sent his son, that was Joseph, to go and look for his brothers where they had gone to look and care for the sheep. But later, when they had lost for a long time, God used this Abraham, this Jacob, to go and look for the brothers. So in this, he had a key message of trying to reach the souls, the people of the same family, to come together and to unite together. Now, this message, we want to translate it in this season of Easter, where God the Father sent his only son, Jesus Christ, to come into the world to look for his own brothers. When we say Jesus is our brother, it is not just a mistake, but he himself said, I have been sent by the Father to you. And when we see this in Luke chapter 19, verse 8, when he met Zacchaeus, the collector, the tax collector, he said the salvation has come in this house. And the reason he came was to look for the lost. And his father sent him for the lost. So in this essence, we want to look at this week of Holy Week, when we are seeing the mission of Jesus Christ reaching many people who were one time lost, who were one time had no hope, who at one time had no anything in relation with God, but because of Jesus' coming. And when we look at this Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and the other days up to Good Friday, people, when they say Good Friday, it is not just for God, but he is concluding his mission of looking for his brothers. So in this very message of Easter, I want to bathe on this theme, that why is God sending his son to this generation, to our generation, to you and me? He has seen that this world, things are going astray. The only hope, the only way is to come back to the Father, like how Joseph had gone to look for his brothers so that they can join together in the family. But when we read deeper in this story of looking for the brother, it needs some good attributes of God. And these are, one, to remain committed to the gospel and the great commission of the Lord. Two, we need to be people of love and concern so that we can reach a number of souls. I know Christ is dying, is going to finish his journey, but what are we learning from him? Jesus has been so committed. He is not even changing a single statement according to his mission. For this, he makes every follower, every disciple, every person, you and me, to remain committed to the same mission of going to reach people outside there. So, friends who are listening to me this day, I want to encourage you that Jesus is leaving a leaf to borrow, that we can reach people in this world, in this place. There are many people in different communities, in different settings, in different groups, who are really in need of this good news of Jesus Christ as he's going to die on the cross. It's not just for dying, but he's bringing us back to his Father. He's bringing and reconciling us back to his Father. And as he reconciles us, what is your role, my brother, my sister, who is listening to me? The first one is to be a responsible person to your brother. There are many people who have been lost in many ways, in other things, in lifestyles, in different behaviors. But this is a time to reflect on Jesus Christ as we are in this Holy Week, that we come and believe the mission of him to redeem us, to change us, to reconcile us to our Father. Many times when people think of Christ's death, they think it is just for the sake of other people, for the sake of so and so. No, it is you and me today. As you listen, that's why we have come in this Holy Week with the message of saying we want to reach this good news. We want to reach people with this nice message of Jesus Christ, that please let it not be just a word of talking. And therefore, I want to read this message, which is in Genesis chapter 37, and this is verse 12 up to 14. When you read that message. But the key message is on verse 16 and 15, where he states very well that he himself, when Jacob sent his son, that very Joseph, he had the message of saying, go to your brothers. And that's why we are coming this message, and we are saying, he replied, I am looking for my brothers. Can you tell me where they are grazing their flock? This message of looking for my brother means a lot into the life of a Christian, into the life of any person. This is where people, sometimes they are not even bothered to think of their family. They are not even bothered to think of their relationship. They are not even bothered to look at where they came from. But this is a message during this Easter time. Think of the Father, who is our Father in heaven, who sent Jesus. Though this was for Joseph, but it can apply to our life right now. As Jesus came, he's looking for you and me, so that we can go back to our Father in heaven by how? One coming and saying, Lord, here I am. Here is my situation. Here are my challenges in life. I need you. I need your death to be significant in my life. I need your sacrifice to be significant in my life. And when Joseph said to the brothers that where are they? This is the very question Jesus is asking as he's going on the cross. That where are the people whom I'm going to die for? Where are these people who looks for Jesus? Where are they? And when we see this, we still say we have an opportunity to come to Jesus, to come to him. I know there may be situations when we look at the life of these younger men who were somewhere taking care of the flock, sometimes they're even miserable. When we hear the statement of Jacob telling Joseph that you go and find out how are they? How are they with the flock? It is the very thing, the question now. Our Father in heaven is trying to use Jesus on the cross in this Easter. How are you? How am I? How is the other person? What about your family? What about your children? What about the business you're in? How are you in relation with your God, the Father in heaven? And once he mentions this, he's like encouraging us to have that chance of coming to the Father. He continues with this lesson, which I want to quote in Hebrews chapter 2, verse 11 to 12. Jesus had a boldness to call us his brothers. And that's why we want to use this message. And that's why we are doing this very message that Jesus said in verse 11, where I want to quote chapter 2, Hebrews chapter 2, verse 11. He states that both the one who makes people holy and those who are made holy are of the same family. So Jesus is not ashamed to call them brothers and sisters. Jesus is going to make us holy in this Easter Holy Week. And if he is so, then he is giving you an opportunity to be the brother or the sister to him, to be in the same fire and be in the same family of our Father who is in heaven. But it's not just for the sake of coming, but there is committing our life. Therefore, I want to use this very moment that as Jesus is going to the cross, how have you committed your life to him? How have you accepted the very Savior who is going to do the redemptive work because of his reconciling power? Sometimes people don't want to reconcile, but Jesus' death is going to reconcile between me and you, between you and your family, between you and other friends, and between you and our Father in heaven. So this is the opportunity I can speak to every soul, to every person who is watching and listening to us, that time has come. Let this Easter not just go without accepting him as the only sacrifice for our life in Jesus' name. I want to encourage you, give your life to Christ so that the one whom God sent to come to we as the brothers and sisters, like how Jacob sent his son Joseph to the brothers, it is the same way we need to go and accept. Not to do like the brothers who did harm to Joseph because they decided to kill him, to do away with him. They thought he's somebody who is a dreamer, who is the wrong person. But in the end, when we hear the story of Joseph, we saw him again coming to another level as somebody in a high leadership. Therefore, as Christ is going to die, don't be one of those who are crucifying him in our evil deeds, but just accept him as a son sent to us so that we take him in a special way in our hearts, in our life. Thank you. May the Lord bless you. And we want to encourage you that take a step to continue serving him as your Lord and Savior. May the Lord bless you.